Dr. P. Nagaraj. He is currently working as assistant professor in the Department of Chemistry, Anna University, Chennai. Earlier, he worked as a scientist in charge at Spices Board of India for 5 years in research and development and also in quality control laboratory. He has finished his PhD in organic chemistry at IIT Delhi. He has also done his MSc Chemical Science at Pondicherry Central University. He has published 6 papers in international journal and also participated several international events in India and abroad. He has attended several conferences and delivered lecture as keynote speaker and also undergone 12 training programs. His area of research interests are isolation, synthesis of natural products and evaluation of their biological activities, carbohydrate-based natural product synthesis, enzyme catalyst organic synthesis, green chemistry, medicinal aspects of spices and spice products.
Welcome to UGC lecture series in polymer science. In polymer science, fiber science and rubber technology, today in this class we are going to discuss about specialty of polymeric material. The content of today's talk is what are specialty of polymers, specialty of polymeric fiber materials, examples for polymeric materials and properties of polymeric fiber materials, especially cellular material and its properties, applications of polymeric material. So, these are all the content we are going to discuss today in this lectures. Specialty of polymeric products like polymeric fibers, many naturally occurring polymeric fibers, proteins are cellulose based, most of them natural polymers are protein based or cellulose based. Out of that, which is origin, either it can come from animal or it can come from plants. In animal origin, wool, mohair, angora, fur, silk, cashmere, alpaca, llama, etc. belongs to animal origin. In case of vegetable origins, cotton, flax, linen, sisal, etc. belongs to vegetable origin. In case of polymeric fibers are referred to as man-made or synthetic or artificial fibers. So, it can be available either naturally or we can go for laboratory synthesis or artificial synthesis or man-made product, which is used in variety of applications including filters, cords, cables and fabrics. So, these are the major applications of this polymeric materials. And fabrics require the fibers undergo a process which gives them a texture. So, in case of fabric, which we have to undergo some kind of process that is will give proper texture to the polymeric fiber materials. In case of fiber textures, for continuous filaments, stable filaments or spun stable filaments. So, these are all the types of filaments which we will discuss in future slides. In case of continuous monofilament, tows or yarns are cut into staples which are subjected to a process often referred to as yarn spinning. So, this is generally we can say yarn spinning, that is one process, and yarn spinning separates the monofilaments and the tangles with a twist or spin into a spun yarn consisting of relatively short filaments whose mechanical interlocking give a reasonable strength, while loose ends offered a bulkier, less silky feel and appearance. So, this process will make less silky and appearance is good appearance, which involves during this yarn spinning. Polymeric fibers, manufacturers of fabrics consist of weaving, knitting and other mills. Many types of fabrics, woven fabrics or cloths are either plain or patterned. On the other hand, loop type, these are all the types of polymeric fiber materials. Knitted fabrics are either circular or flat, there are two types, and tufted fabrics are produced as cut or uncut pile. Stitch or bonded fabrics rely on a secondary fiber to hold the primary yarns in a given pattern, and non-woven fabrics are subdivided into bonded webs that make use of polymeric binder to hold a continuous or a staple yarn together. Needle punch felts, which involves a mechanical type interactions. So, fiber forming polymers are normally crystallizing uncross linked type that have a high degree of orientations. So these are all the peculiar property while making polymeric fiber material. It have cross linking in order to increase the strength, and which is have crystallization. Crystallization is nothing but is a proper orientation of arrangements of this polymeric material, which will give high degree of orientation. That based on the orientation, the strength of the material can be subjected to find it. In case of monofilaments, range from 3 to 15 denier for a specific gravity of 1.3, a titer of 10 denier corresponds to a diameter of 0.03 mm. Hosiery usually involves filament of 15 denier titer. So, this is the measurement of which involved in textile process, especially in fiber or fabrics. Characterization of this polymeric material: long established textile industry developed specific methods and an associated jargon to characterize fiber and associated units. Fiber dimensions. So, this is the dimension of fibers reported as titer in denier, mass in gram of 9000 meter of monofilament or multifilament yarn. So, this is dimension. And apparel may involve 12 filament twisted yarn with a global 50 denier titer, and the tire cord may involve 2448 filament untwisted yarn with a global 15000 denier titer. The fiber strength is often reported as tenacity in force per unit titer. So, for a specific gravity 1.3, tenacity 6 denier correspond to a tensile strength of 100 psi, that means 700 MPa. So, this is basically involved the strength of the fiber material. Based on that strength, we can use for different applications. So, this is a specific terminology which involved in a textile industry. The tenacity of common fibers is in the range of 3 to 9, and the fiber moduli range from 30 to 50 corresponding to 3.1 psi. And next, which is important thing is processing. Formation of monofilaments involve two basic steps, step 1 and step 2. The first step, which involves filament spinning, formation of the filament or as a spin monofilament, which is semi crystalline but non oriented. The first step, which involves totally, it is not semi crystalline, means it is not fully crystallized form. And second thing is orientation, that is another important thing, which is not fully oriented or non oriented in the first step. Step 2, cold drying or drying confers most of the orientation through a stretching, yielding and a drying process that takes place in the solid state, but above the TG of the crystallization polymer. So, TG is nothing but thermogravimetry analysis, glass transition temperature, that polymer material particular temperature, it will exist as a glassy, then it will go to rubbery stage. So, glassy state to rubbery state, that is called a glass transition temperature. Up to that particular temperature, the polymer material will be flexible. So, based on that, they will, step 2 will make the polymer to more orientation and more crystallization process. The monofilament in final form is drawn a filament. A filament spinning achieved in several ways: chemical reaction during the fiber forming stage, or transformation, or only physical involving heat or mass transfer. There are two methods we can make this filament spinning, either in the chemical or in physical method. So, involving some mass transfer method you can make to use this. And another important thing is wet spinning, which involves the extrusion of a liquid like a fluid through small holes of a spinner in a bath containing another fluid which is extruded strand interacts either chemically or through molecular exchange. So, dry spinning, now wet spinning also we can use some chemicals. After sufficient interaction and residence time, the strand becomes solid and aspen monofilament. So, the fiber material coated with some kind of chemical which will give more strength to the fabric or fiber materials. Processing again, dry spinning involves the extrusion of a concentrated polymer solutions through small spinner net holes. Emerging strands are then dried. Solvent is evaporated by cross flow if air. Difficulties in handling the solvents. So, some of the chemical solvents which can be employed during dry spinning, where the solvent can be removed, and what depend upon this nature of solvent and what kind of application we need the fiber material, we can choose those material, we can make the spinning process. Melt spinning involves extrusion of a molten polymer through relatively large spinneret holes, and its cooling and solidification is a cross flow of air. Difficult is in the thermal stability of the melt and its high viscosity. So, dry process, wet process, another one is melt process, that depend upon the nature of fibric material, we can heat it and it will come to melt stage. So, there we can bring the spinning process, which is very difficult because the melt and its high viscosity. While doing the melt, the fiber materials will be more viscous in nature. During the spinning, it is very difficult to compare to wet process or dry process. Strands are rapidly pulled, elongated as they emerge from spinner net holes, primarily in order to reduce the diameter. Acrylic and acetate fibers are wet or dry spun. So, we can choose this polymeric fiber material like acrylic and acetate, which involve wet or dry spun. Polyamides, polyolefins and polyesters are commonly melt spuns. So, this there are all polymer or fiber material can't used any one method. So, there are some polymer material or fiber material can use for this wet method, or some of them used in melt method. Commercial types, 7 major types of polymeric fibers, which is first one is a rayon, which is viscose rayon fibers are sold as regular, cross linked or high wet modulus types. So, another one is acetate or triacetate fibers are based upon the cellulose acetate, and the third one is olefinics, includes polyethylenes and polypropylenes. So, this broadly we can categorize based on the commercial types, rayon, acetates and olefinic. All are prepared in different methods as we discussed earlier slide, like wet method, dry method or melt method. And the fourth one is vinylidene, vinylenics based on PVC, polyvinyl chloride, but also with copolymerization with vinyl acetate or vinylidene chloride. And the another one is acrylics based on the PAN, polyacrylonitrile, but can involve copolymerization with PVC, polyvinyl chloride. And the sixth one is polyamides or nylons, involves aliphatic polyamides. Polyamides nothing but amide groups, CONH2, which is present in the polymeric material. The last one is polyester, which involves PET, polyethylene terephthalate is a ester, which is widely used polyester fiber material in this world. And special purpose are high performance fibers are polyurethanes, aramides, extended chains, PBA and PEEK, polyethyl ethyl ketone. Polymeric films, which is widely used in the form of wide products of uniform thickness. Films means the thickness should be uniform, especially in the recently developed nano science, mostly people thin film coating. So, any material want to be coated, the coating should be very thin, which is uniform concentration, and the thin layers also will be very uniform. The film is associated with the thickness of less than 0.25 millimeter, you can see very low millimeter, thickness between 0.04 millimeter or 0.001 to 1 millimeter. So, dry cleaning garments bags are made from LDPE low density polyethylene at a thickness of 0.013 or 0.5 mils thick. A sheet is thicker than the 0.25 millimeter. So, this is thin film material, fiber material. Plastic film is manufactured in flat extrusions and thin rolls. Film casting are calendaring and tubular extrusions blowing. Uniaxial or biaxial molecular orientation can be obtained using a flat stretching device or through the bubble process improves properties. Subjected to several standard tests, burst resistance, tear resistance, puncture resistance, folding endurance, slip, curl and resealability. So, these are all the tests which all the fiber materials or fabric material will undergo before coming to the application part of you. Polymeric film materials, regenerated cellulose and CLE, cellophane, used for many years and can be coated with thermoplastic for heat sealings. Cellulose nitrate, cyanogroups and cellulose acetate were the earliest film. LDPE, low density polyethylene, and HDPE, high density polyethylene, most common film materials. Polypropylene, PP, is generally used as a oriented PP or OPP. Ionomers, IO, are suril or olefin related film materials. PVC is used in plasticized form. So, these are all material whatever we discussed here, which is used thin film polymeric materials. PVDC or sarin wrap is used in copolymer form with 10 to 50% acrylonitrile or with ethylene vinyl acetate or ethylene vinyl alcohol, so which can be used for this PVDC. PET is used in film form for mylar sheet. PS polysulfones is used as a biaxially oriented film or for thermoforming sheet. And polycarbonate PC, polysulfone PSU, polyimides PI, polyethylamides PEI, which can be used as a thin film polymeric materials. So, polymeric film materials, again composite films, can be defined as parallel layers of different materials designed to offer a set of properties not possessed by either materials. Coating or laminations of material, example paper or foils, which again involves this kind of polymeric material, thin film polymeric materials. Multilayer films are made by co-extrusion with each layer, mechanical strength, especially polyethyl tetralite, and sealing polyethylenes, barrier PVDC, and adhesives are needed to form bonds between layers. Complex co-extrusion dies can be handled over 10 layers or used for tubular or flat extrusion. So, if different purpose like a barrier, if you need, you can use these kind of polymers. In case of sealing, you need PE. In case of mechanical strength, you can use PET. So, depend upon the requirement of your fiber material, you can coat this polymeric material thin film. You can coat over the fiber material. You can increase the mechanical strength or sealing properties or barrier. Barrier means it should not exchange gas, especially suppose if we are going to use packing material. Packing material means it should be whatever material you packed, that should not leak any gases, especially oxygen or moisture. If enters any moisture or oxygen, it will spoil the product. In such a way, the packing material should be barrier resistant. So, such a case, people will go for this kind of polymer material in case of packing. Polymeric film applications like a mechanical packaging, as we discussed, like packaging is a play major role, especially polymeric fiber materials. So, applications that requires mechanical resistance of the film. So, whatever film we are coating over the fiber material, which should be mechanically stable or more mechanical strength should be there. And barrier packaging, displacing traditional packaging in glass or metal containers. So, what we are using now, fiber material, it should have coated with barrier packaging material that can be replaced with the traditionally used glasses as well as containers. Some are flexible like bags or pouches for food items. Some are rigid like a yogurt containers and margarine tubes. So, we can make both way using fiber materials like a flexible as well as a rigid material, which can be used to depend upon our requirement. Packaging is essential for sanitary and conservation reasons and should retard the deterioration, spoilage. It should not get spoilage of foods. Example, decay, decoloration of meats, staleness of breads. So, if whatever material you are using for packing, which have a polymeric coating, it should not interfere with our food item or food materials. So, if it is interfere, then there is no point of using such a polymeric material or fiber material. Again, the barriers packaging involves control of, it should control especially oxygen, carbon dioxide and water, which will be highly danger. If it is enter into the packaging material, it will spoil the food product as well as packed products. food characteristic are aroma, odor, scent of food, oils and fats. And next one is food containers, heat resistant packaging for boiling, cooking and baking, which requires sterilization of 120 degree Celsius above the boiling point of water, and the control of oxygen, nitrogen and carbon dioxide. So, wherever if you go for packaging or packing material, it should be completely sealed or blocked with oxygen. It should be a barrier for oxygen and moisture. These two are very danger in whatever food material, it will go as spoilage. Liquid food stuffs includes soups, beverages, wine, soda, water, liquor can be packaged with plastics and are replacing glass containers. So, nowadays the fiber thin film coated material, which is used for packaging material, especially liquid foods like soups, beverage, wine, soda, water, liquor, and which is easily replaced plastic materials or glass materials. Now, fiber materials, which is very important for packaging of liquid items. Carbonated beverages can develop up to 100 psi pressures and require resistant to carbon dioxide permeations, which is very, very important, like soda, lime soda or whatever may be carbonated beverages, which is develop pressure inside the packing material more than 100. So, the material should not get break. So, such a way our polymeric thin film coated material, fiber material, which is play major role, especially it should not allow the CO2 to escape, then the taste or whatever the property that will go bad. So, it should not permeable for CO2, such a way we can to make the materials. Semi-fluid food stuffs include the dressing, mayonnaise, relishes and tomato ketchup, sauce and jelly, jam or preserves. So, this kind of semi-solid material or waxy type material also to be packed using our polymeric coated fiber materials. Food containers, like most solid foods, are candidates for all plastic packaging, but there are large differences in the requirement that are associated with the food and the intended use. Animal products required odor control, water barrier and controlled oxygen permeations, and frozen poultry is shrink wrapped, and dairy products includes milk and cheese wraps. So, these are all different upon the product, we have to choose different material, especially here solid foodstuffs, all are solid material, for them separate packing should be there, it should not allow especially oxygen. Next, bakery products like bread, cakes, pies must be wrapped with suitable water barrier to prevent premature drying. So, our bakery items, if it is it should always exist as a soft nature. If it is changed from soft to some dry, it is dried, then it may not be suitable for eating, such a way it should not allow any water either from inside or outside. So, moisture should not enter in the packed material. Dry foods includes cereals, biscuits, coffee, snacks, foods, chips require moisture and oxygen to be kept out and aroma to be kept in. So, which is very, very important peculiar property, like moisture and water should not be there inside, it should not allow. At the same time, whatever fragrant smell which is present in our food material, it should not go out also. Such a way the packing material should be specially made it to, should not it act as a barrier. So, confectionery includes chocolates products whose high oil content requires oil resistant acrylonitrile based film, which is very suitable for this kind of application. And mechanical film packaging applications include LDPE and HDPE, thick gauged sacks for powdered or granular products, garbage and trash bags, generated merchandise and t-shirt bags, thin gauge dry cleaning garments, covers and florist wraps. So, based on the usage of this, like a garbage and a thick solid material, we are going for LDPE or HDPE, depend upon our requirement, we can choose any one of the polymeric coated fiber materials. And heat shrinkable, it should not shrinkage upon heating, biaxially stretched, can be made with LDPE, PVC, PPE, etcetera. So, this kind of special property we can get using low density polyethylene and polyvinyl chloride polypropylene will give this kind of heat sinking bubbles. Sinking is achieved with hot water, hot air convection or radiation. Using this either water, hot water or hot air or radiation, we can get sinking. A stretch wrapped by winding a thin plastic tape under some controlled tensions. You can use any method to make this kind of polymers. And the construction and public works uses for polymer film, construction coverings, roof liners, industrial liners, agriculture for silo covers, water reservoirs, liners. Another class which is a cellular polymers, polymers can be combined with a gas which will give cellular polymers, forms voids or cells in the polymer causing the polymer to be very light, referred to as cellular blown expanded polymer. Foam, elastomeric foam, matrix is an elastomer or rubber which belongs to cellular polymer. Flexible foam, soft plastic matrix like a plasticized PVC, PPVC, LDPE and PU. Rigid foams are PS, polysulfones, unsaturated polyesters, phenolics, urethane, etc. So, this is elastomeric, flexible foam, rigid foams. Type of polymer matrix, thermoplastics or thermoset can form plastics for classification, basic classifications. So, thermosetting and thermoplastic. Thermosetting means if you heat it, it will get more strong, further heating it will burn or break up. Whereas, thermoplastic which will melt, if you heat it, it will melt, you can mold it, you can make it or you can reuse this kind of material. The amount of gas added reflects the resulting density. So, light foams, the density 0.01 to 0.1 and dense foams, the density 0.4 to 0.6. Cellular polymer, the arrangements and distribution of gas in the cellular polymer corresponds to the structure of the foam. So, here you can see this is the matrix where gas which is present in the matrix, the closed cells. So, this is one of the example for cellular polymers. So, the polymer material contain in between gaseous molecules which is two types, closed cell and open cell. Closed cell which is spherical or roughly spherical voids are fully separated by matrix materials, which we can see here. This is closed cell, you can see the which is completely closed with the spherical shape, and another one is open cell, and the spherical or roughly spherical voids or interconnections occurs between the cells. The degree of interconnections can be assessed if a sample is subjected to a moderate vacuum and a liquid is allowed to flow into the interconnections and cause the weight to increase. You can see another open cell which is again have this kind of voids which is interlinked each other. So, this is a glass molecule, this is a matrix, there you can see the interconnections. So, this is the difference between this closed cell and open cell. Cell size is important for heat and mass transfer. Cell density with the number of cells per unit cross sectional area or volume characterizes the coarseness or fineness of foam. A structural foam, foamed core is sandwiched between solid skins. A structural foam between integral skins. Foaming can give an inhomogeneous structure. Closed cellular polymers, nature of the entrapped gas may have an effect on certain properties or suitability for specific applications. Air, nitrogen, water, pentane, methylene, chloride, fluorohydrocarbon, vapors can be used as a blowing agent. So, wherever you can use these kind of gases, you can use. Amount of gas changes with the time as the gas moves through the materials and exits to the atmosphere leaving a cellular structure. So, cellular polymer can be made by using these gases. Mechanism for the formation of cellular structure, aeration or frothing, mechanical agitation is used to incorporate air into liquid resin systems which is involved latex or reactive urethane. Physical blowing agents are add nitrogen gas into a solutions or to liquid melt which comes out of solutions where pressure is released and forms cells. add liquids at room temperature and have a low boiling point. The liquids vaporize upon heating or by chemical reaction heat. Aliphatic hydrocarbons like a pentane, methylene chloride, trichlorofluoromethanes or freon, which can be used for that purpose. Mechanism for the formation of cellular structure, chemical blowing agents or compounds that decomposes under heat and liberate large amount of an inert gas like nitrogen CO2 or CO, water, ammonia, hydrogens. Activators can sometimes be added to allow lower decomposition temperature and release more gas at lower temperature. So, summary, we have seen what are specialty of polymers and specialty of polymeric fiber materials, examples for some of polymeric materials, properties of polymeric fiber materials, cellular materials and its properties, application of polymeric materials. Questions: what are specialty of polymers, raw material for specialty of polymers, explain with examples of polymeric material, what are the cellular material, explain with suitable examples, explain the applications of polymeric fiber materials. With this, we conclude. Thank you.